while she was writing Tears Dry on Her Own, I just happened to stumble across, you know, the original files of Ain't No Mountain High Enough. As I listened to the instrumental of Ain't No Mountain High Enough, I just heard So I heard similarities in the movement of the song. But once again, her song was written different tempo, different space. I just heard it going, wait a minute, this is playing this way, that can play that way. And Amy could not hear it for the life of her. So she was pissed at me. You know what? I mean, I'm going to try it because it's you, but like, for real, this is not going to happen. Like, this is way too fast. How can I sing it that fast? So it was a lot of mad at the world going on, like, you sing it yourself.
Okay, I don't understand. Why do I stress a man when there's so many bigger things ahead? And again, let me start from the beginning.
This just didn't happen. These were rarities as far as Amy needing to do a vocal over and over.
Even if I stop wanting you, I'm respecting you.
It was basically frustration for the first time and the only time in our creative process was the frustration with doing the vocals. But when it finally got right, it made all the difference in the world.
He walks away, the sun goes down. He takes the day, but I'm grown. And in your way, in this blue shade, my tears dry on their own.
Her confidence in being able to write a song the way she felt it and not being forced to use some type of formula was there. So whether it was short or long, was it good?
Salaam was one of the very few people that could speak to Amy and communicate with her and her listen. He was very good at coaxing stuff out of her. If she was having a writer's block or if she wasn't getting it. And even though Mark was central to Back to Black coming together, so was Salaam. And I don't think you could have had one without the other.
He walks away. The sun goes down.